Hey guys, I'm back with a new review. As you can tell, this is nothing big this time, not nice and small. Beast Wars Mutants Poison Bite. Yes, this is a mutant. This is not your usual Maximal Predacon type deal. This is a Transformer that pretty much has no robot mode. It goes straight from Beast Mode to Beast Mode, which I think could throw a lot of people off, and I'm pretty sure that has been the case where they bought this guy thinking he would transform and do something cool, and oh look, it's another Beast Mode. I actually like that gimmick. I like the idea of it. I think he looks pretty cool. This is his Barracuda mode, or, you know, as the song goes, Barracuda. I like him. He actually looks very, very nice. Let me zoom out just a little bit. You know, his detailing is pretty cool. His mouth, it's Barracuda-esque. He has these really nice little blue eyes. You can really catch the light in there. He looks nice. I mean, it's a Barracuda, you know. It's the little tail fin type section here. You can say this does have some kind of articulation if you want. I pretty much just leave it like that. I don't know. His little flippers on the front here can move up and down. They're on a ball joint. You can have them, you know, type thing. And his jaw does open and close. Pretty cool. So, Poison Bite and the other mutants, there are four. There's Icebird, who goes from a polar bear, I think, to an owl, perhaps. There's Razorclaw, and there is one more that the name is slipping my mind. Soundwave! There we go! Hey! There's four of them that I know of. There may be more, there may not be. These guys, actually, I didn't know this. I tried to look this guy up a little bit before I did the review, because he doesn't appear that much, as far as I know. These guys were actually planned in the Animorphs toy line. And we know how those turned out. The Animorphs were really bad Transformers. Their alternate modes looked okay, but their human modes were just grisly. They were pathetic. So I'm kind of curious what would have led to these guys being made. But after the Animorphs subline, the Animorphs toy line, sorry, was canceled, they retooled the mutants for the Beast Wars toys, which that's kind of confusing. I mean, I'm curious to see what would have happened if these had been released at Animorphs, you know, what would have been changed and so on. But enough of that. Very cool little figure. Let me zoom out a teeny tad bit so I can see what I'm doing here. To transform this guy, he's really not that difficult. Mine did not come with instructions, which I know makes a lot of you guys go, well, what are you talking about? But just bear with me here. Start off, fold down his little fins in the back, give me just a little bit, all the way if you want, don't really matter. Fold these little flippers up to cover his face, and then take this little panel here, and that's going to rotate around on his back. Cover his little face up just like that. Reach into the sides here on his panels and slide them open. So you give him a nice little winged look. You could say he's a triple changer and these are his wings. I if you want to go right ahead, I don't really care. Now, the way I had mine transformed, I had the ball joints, you know, facing front like this. And that makes it so when I want to transform into his other mode, I can just fold outwards like that. And it just shoots right out. It's really nice and it's easy and it's simple. It's fantastic. Your little tail fin may get split in half already. That's perfectly fine. It's going to do that. Don't worry. It's not a weapon, it's not violent, it's not gonna kill a baby, it's not gonna punt anything. I like assaulting small things, apparently. So go ahead and take the front here, split that in half. These will be his claws for a second mode that I haven't revealed yet. Fold this front part forward, this will be the face, and you can probably already tell what's coming out of this mode. You can position the claws, you know, little certain ways if you want. Obviously something kind of like that would look best and ideal. And if you really cannot tell what this is yet, this should be a dead giveaway. Flip this little part forward and come on, think about it. It's getting there. Now you're pretty much about done. All that's ever left to do is take his tail section, slide that forward. There's a little hole right here and there's a peg right here. So those are going to, of course, you know, like the birds and the bees, they're going to meet in their certain manner and then combine. Repeat with the other side. I shouldn't have to explain that. And once that's done, just kind of rearrange the tail section into feet, legs, if you will, and rearrange the front, the claws, and you are done. That is Poison Bite in his Scorpion mode. And you know what? It actually looks pretty good. It looks like a scorpion. He can stand up pretty well. I mean, he only has two legs on the front here, so there's nothing supporting his back, but it actually works. Scorpions are normally kind of flat animals, so he's supposed to be kind of down low if you want, but you can have him, I think his legs position here, you can have him kind of upright, and of course he fell over his, right as I praised him for his balance and being able to stand. That's my toys for you. They are out to discredit everything that I say and do, which I'm perfectly okay with. You know, it happens from time to time. Go ahead and zoom back in on him. Come on. Come on, baby. Zoom in for daddy. Come on. Oh. I don't know why it's doing that. I'm holding the button down. Now, the Scorpion mode is very much like the Barracuda. He has the exact same paint scheme. He has some added features in that I think was kind of pointless. Maybe it's just me. One thing that is kind of cool, he does have his insignia. That is the Mutant's little logo. Not Maxwell, not Predacon. Getting a little closer on that. Just kind of cool. Now, the Mutants, from what I understand, each had their own little special type thing. They would have, like, mechanical parts thrown in. I don't have any other Mutants, so I can't really confirm this, but where the symbol is, take this little panel and fold it open, and we have, if I can get it open, a mechanical parts of some kind. It doesn't do anything, it's just there for looks, but it's an added feature that's kind of interesting, I guess. And lastly, this is just weird to me. Take his tail, when you fold it up, push down the claw, and hello! We get a robot face. That is Poison Bite's actual robot head. Okay. I don't know why that was thrown in. It seems like a kind of a weird little gimmick to me. But you know what? The Mutants are about being weird. You know, they're not about your normal mainstream Transformers. They're about having fun, having a good time, with something that would probably scare your parents after death if they saw it in person. Now, I don't know why he's not standing very well. He was actually standing rather well before. I think it's he's camera shy, and that makes him a little, you know, kind of not really scared, but just like he wants to act up for attention. Stay. Now, Poison Bite, it is presumed that he was one of, I'm saying presumed because I don't really know diddly about this guy. It is presumed that him and the other mutants were among the Maxwells that were jettisoned from the Axalon. Axon? Axalon? Axoff? I don't know. When it arrived on prehistoric Earth and remained in orbit for quite a period of time. They did appear in the IDW books. I think they're even Beast Wars The Gathering, and mine is around here somewhere, and I could, I guess, skim through that while I'm talking. Supposedly, they do appear in Beast Wars The Gathering, and it's black and white, so I cannot make out who's who by just skimming. Although that does look kind of like a scorpion. I don't know. Ah, here we go. There's Poison Bite right there attacking. I honestly cannot tell. Retracts, maybe? Well, Alex, because I've been looking at him right here, and that's him, so. Yeah, you got Poison Bite, and I'm guessing that's Razor Claw too, maybe. But, you know, so, oh, and there's Soundwave, so they do appear in Beast Wars The Gathering. And there's Icebird, see. So they do appear this, they appear in the 3H books, and they appear in the Fun publications, which I think is mainly from like, the Transformers Collectors Club type thing. So they are mainstream characters, they just didn't appear in the show at all, which would make people probably not like them. If you are a fan of Beast Wars and you don't mind having a Transformer that goes from Beast Mode to Beast Mode, there's no Robot Mode, I would highly recommend at least this Mutant. He looks pretty cool. I mean, I may actually display him in the Scorpion Mode, and he comes packaged in the Barracuda Mode. They both look really good in terms of a toy that goes from a Beast to a Beast type thing, if that makes any sense. I would highly recommend them, and I do hope to find the others someday. Maybe not someday soon. But that's it, guys. I am done. Thanks for watching. We have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.